with the pectoral region and the blood supply along with the lymphatic drainage and the diseases associated with the lymphatic drainage of the breast. So the breast is the most prominent and the superficial structure present in the interior chest wall, and it is especially prominent in the female at the time of puberty and after the puberty, and it has become enlarged during the pregnancy and lactation because of the proliferation of the glandular parenchyma of the mammary gland that is present in the breast. So at the puberty, the breast is gradually enlarged and assume their hemispherical in shape, and it is just because of the the enlargement under the influence of the ovarian hormone. The duct elongated, but the increase in the size of the gland is mainly because of the deposition of the fat during the pubertal age, and the fat is decreases during the proliferation of the gland parenchyma and the alveolar hypertrophy. Okay, so it is somewhat spherical and semicircular in appearance, and it lies on the superficial connective tissue of the anterior chest wall, and just below that there is the anterior chest wall and the muscles of the pectoral region. So it is present in the subcutaneous tissue. That's why it is supposed to be as a type of a modified sweat gland, and it is suspended by some supportive tissue from the skin, and that supportive tissue not only suspend the breast tissue but also provide the septation and the separation of the lobules and its proper area in the breast tissue. Okay, so the base of the breast is or the bed of the breast is extend from the second intercostal second rib to the sixth rib. So the vertically the extent of the breast is in the from the second to the sixth rib, and its transverse or the horizontal extension is from the lateral margin of the sternum up to the mid axillary line. So it is somewhat circular, but its extent, vertical extent and the horizontal extent is from the second to the sixth rib, and horizontally from the lateral margin of the sternum up to the mid axillary line. Small part of the breast tissue is deep to the it pierces the deep fascia of the anterior chest wall and interior pectoral wall, and it lies into the deep fascia that is called the axillary tail, but we will discuss it later on. So the greater part of the most of the part is in the superficial fascia of the anterior thoracic region, and the nipples are the small rounded area, and it is surrounded by a dark pigmented area called the alula, and this as we have discussed that the nipple is the area where all the lactiferous duct open up through the sinus. So it provides the opening of the duct to the exterior. Okay, this is the again a cut section that shows the multiple lactiferous, the lobular structure and the lactiferous duct drained by the lactiferous duct, and the duct open up into the nipple, and before they open up there is a dilatation, and that dilatation is called as a lactiferous sinus. So each breast is consist of 15 to 20 lobules. Main duct of the breast is the lactiferous duct, and they submitted all the smaller duct open up into the large lactiferous duct and ultimately terminate into the lactiferous sinus. Around the skin of the alula we have a tubercular appearance, and that is called the Montgomery tubercle. They are the type of a sweat glands. Now the axillary tail is a part of a breast. It protruded out in prolongated and protruded deep into the fascia into the outer quadrant, and it pierces and enters into the axillary fascia. So that's why it is called as a axillary tail. So axillary tail of the breast is of have a surgical importance because sometimes it is palpable due to the glandular changes occurring during menstruation or during the lactation, and so they may become palpable, and it is supposed to be misdiagnosed as a enlarged lymph node or the lipoma. deep relation of the breast is that the breast is lies on the superficial fascia. So deep to the breast are the deep fascia, and the deep fascia containing the muscle called the pectoralis major, serratus anterior. So the four muscles are formed deep to the breast, pectoralis major containing most of the content of the breast. So it is in the breast bed. Beside the pectoralis major, serratus anterior, external oblique muscles, and this portion of the latissimus dorsi may also be present deep to the breast tissue. So if we take the cut section, the breast is a conical projected area present on the skin, and the skin gives the septas. The septas are present, and these septas are called as a suspensory ligament. They support, they separate the lobules of the gland and provide the attachment of the glandular structure to the skin. So they act as a suspensory type of tissue. So that's why it's called a suspensory ligament of Cooper. Behind the breast, there is a space in between the skin and the breast and the deep fascia of the pectoralis major. There is a space, and that space is termed to be as a retro memory space, and it is filled up with the thin layer of the fatty tissue and provide the free movement of the breast over the anterior chest wall or the pectoralis fascia. Okay, so the septas divided the lobule breast tissue into multiple lobule, drained by the duct, lactiferous duct, and drain into the lactiferous sinus, open up into the multiple separate opening through the nipple, and it is covered by the highly pigmented areolar tissue. Now the blood supply of the breast is that the breast is supplied by the three sources. The three branches of the three branches arises from the axillary artery, the internal mammary artery or the branch of the subclavian artery, and the branches from the posterior intercostal. So three main sources are the basic main supply of the breast tissue. The branches that arises from these main supply is that the medial part of the breast is supplied by the internal mammary arteries. These are the branches of the subclavian artery, although they arises from the thoracocerebral trunk of the subclavian arteries. The upper quadrant, upper lateral part is supplied by the rectal, and the outer quadrant are supplied by the lateral thoracic and the thoracoacromial artery. These are the branches of the axillary artery. And the lower part is the lower outer quadrant is supplied by the posterior branches of the posterior intercostal artery. So the venous drainage is similarly more or less similar to the arterial supply. The medial part is drained into the subclavian through the internal mammary artery veins. The lower part is drained by the lower outer part is drained by the posterior intercostal veins. Upper part is drained by the subclavian and the axillary vein. So the metastasis of this outer quadrant of the breast is into the vertebral column is through the posterior intercostal vein. So it communicate and it vertebral through the vertebral canal, it open up into the brain and metastasize easily into the brain tissue. That's why the posterior intercostal vein drain the breast, communicate to the vertebral vein, and then they continues to drain into the intracranial vein. Ultimately, that is the root of the the metastasis transformation of the malignant tissue from the breast to the brain. Okay, again a summary picture that shows the medial side supplied by the internal mammary artery, the outermost side by the lateral thoracic and the thoracoacromial arteries, and the lateral outer quadrant by the perforating branches of the posterior intercostal arteries and the axillary posterior intercostal arteries. Venous drainage is more or less similar to the arterial supply. Now the important is the lymphatic drainage. So the lymphatic drainage of this breast is divided into four quadrants. So we divide the breast into the outer quadrant, outer lower quadrant, and the outer upper quadrant, and we divide the outer the inner lateral medial quadrant and the inner lower quadrant. So the most of the inner medial and the inner lower quadrant, it drain into the internal thoracic group of lymph node, while rest of the part of the breast, that is majority of the upper outer quadrant and the lower quadrant, part of the lower quadrant, it drained into the axillary group of lymph node. So the axillary group of lymph node play a very important role in the lymphatic drainage of the breast. And so the identification of the breast carcinoma is, first is the enlargement of the or obstruction of the axillary group of lymphatic drainage. So lymphatic drainage of the mammary gland is of the great clinical importance, and its development of the carcinoma in the gland is detected by the enlargement of the gland axillary lymph node. Lateral quadrant of the breast drain into the anterior or the pectoral group of lymph node. Pectoral group is situated just posterior to the border of the anterior border of the pectoralis major muscle. Medial quadrant is mainly drained into the internal thoracic. So it, the site of these may combine or may metastasize to the opposite side, because they are present on the medial side and they drain into the opposite side of the medial aspect of the internal thoracic group of lymph node. Few lymph vessels follow the posterior intercostal artery, so the outer lower quadrant may be metastasized or may drain into the posterior intercostal artery, and they ultimately drain into the posterior periaortic group of lymph node. But now the lower outer medial quadrant, they drain the deep vessels, they drained up into the not only into the abdominal or the parathoracic group, but they deep down into the anterior abdominal wall, and they drain into the subdiaphragmatic or the deep in abdominal group of lymphatic drainage. So the symptoms of the breast cancer is the palpation or the enlargement of the lymph node or the feeling of the lump, and there are two types of lump could be found. One is the metastatic type of tumor lump, or the second is the non-metastasized or the benign type of lump. Usually the glandular hypertrophy may lead into the fibroadenoma type of enlargement, but these are usually the non-metastasis and the non-malignant type of tumor, while the adenocarcinoma are mainly the metastatic type of tumor. The detection of the tumor or the cyst or any abnormality could be by the scan known as a mammograph. The mammogram shows the breast parenchymal tissue, and if any abnormality could be present, it could be found into the this scan, that is the benign cyst could be found, the calcification could be detected, the carcinomatous enlargement could be found in the mammogram. So the breast cancer could be of it is the most second cause of the death in the whole population, and first cause is the in the female of population death is the breast cancer. So the it could be of two type, the common type, the ductal carcinoma and the lobular or the parenchymal carcinoma. Ductal carcinoma are more they are the more metastatic, more these are the more called as a highly growth, highly viral type of virulent type of tumor that could be easily metastasized and could be easily turned into the metastasization into the different body tissue. So it could be through the lymphatic drainage, it could be drained into the lung, into the bone and the brain, and may be determined after the detected after the metastasization takes place. Mammogram is the one of the most common modality used for the diagnosis, early detection of the breast tumor. So early detection means the increase good prognosis of the early diagnosis and the good prognosis. The sign of metastatic, the sign of the lymphatic drainage obstruction in the breast tumor is giving a specific appearance called the pudia orange or the pitted dimple appearance on the skin just because of the obstruction of the lymphatic drainage and the appearance of the fluid tissue, and the suspensory ligaments is attached with the skin, and then because of the obstruction it gives the dimpling of the skin, and it gives as a orange skin appearing like appearance. Okay, so every young female and the female should do their self breast examination for the detection of any lump, any abnormality, any color change, any discharge from the nipple, and it is suggested to do a self breast examination once in a month. An ideal time for the examination is second to third day after the periods started, because the glandular tissue are not under the influence of the hormones and they are the smooth tissue. The steps are clearly mentioned. It should be done with the fingers, and it could be done in the all quadrant of the breast, in from upward to downward, in the circular and the wedge shape. And if examination could be done into the mirror to identify any